The world is a very big place, and the people of the world are all very different. Not only is every person different, but communities as a whole have cultures and traditions that make them unique. It is important to respect these differences and realize that no culture and no skin color is better than any other. Today you guys will learn about the differences between the US and India. I visited India for only 3 weeks and my experiences there changed my life forever. My first impressions were not the greatest. After getting off the plane, we had about an hour drive to the hotel and I was shocked. One of the first things I noticed was how much garbage was along the side of the road and also how beat up the buildings were. Outside of the cities, there were neighborhoods full of beat up shacks with stray dogs and cows, and here's where they would go to the bathroom in these villages. In the US, there are many organizations that clean up the community, and neighborhoods usually look more like this. Another part about India that initially shocked me was the traffic. As you can see here, the streets in India are crazy, and it seems like there's no traffic laws. Here's a picture of me from inside one of their cabs, which they call rickshaws. This is very different from the US, where there are strict speed limits and traffic laws. Now let's talk about the people of India. Unlike the US, who has a variety of cultures everywhere, in India, almost everyone is Indian. You would think this would make me as a white American feel uncomfortable, but in fact, it was just the opposite. Everyone was very welcoming and friendly towards me and treated me as a guest of their country. This kindness that I received from everyone I met is really what made me appreciate Indian people in general. Throughout my time there, I made multiple friends who taught me a lot about India. One day I was working with a physical therapist who invited me into his home for a traditional Indian lunch. In this small house lived his mom, aunt, brothers, and grandma, which is normal for an Indian household. His mom was worried about the food and worried it would be too spicy because most food in India is very spicy, but it was delicious. In India, they eat with their hands, but they assured me that I didn't have to. As you can see, the food they eat is much different than what we usually eat in the US. By talking to him, I learned that most of India is deeply religious, and it's part of their religion to be hospitable and respectful to each other. In the US, people sometimes are rude and selfish to each other, so it was refreshing to be around such kind people who had so little, yet they were so happy. Their religion has different holidays, and I happened to be there during their biggest one called Pongal, where they worship their various gods, like the one you see here. They celebrate by drawing flowers like this all over town. They also celebrate with music and dancing, like the show I was able to see here. I also learned that many marriages are arranged and last 3 to 7 days, and divorce is very uncommon, unlike in the US. Most Indian people make their money through family-owned businesses like the ones in the market you see here. As you can see, it's much different than a traditional grocery store in the US. As I'm sure you've noticed, Indian clothing is also much different than here in the US, where people dress more like this family. Although the United States and India have countless differences like the clothes we wear, in our hearts we are all the same and no culture is better than any other. At first glance, I thought I would hate my visit, but the extraordinary people there proved me wrong. India has taught me not to judge a book by its cover, and I will carry that with me always.